senators and representatives, I have the distinguished honor of presenting the President of the United States.
President, Mr. Speaker, members of the Senate, of the House of Representatives, yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation, and at the solicitation of Japan, was still in conversation with its government and its emperor, looking toward the maintenance of peace in the Pacific.
It all started with one attack by the Japanese on Pearl Harbor. America had tried to stay neutral at this point, but this led them into the war. From here, the U.S. split into two separate fleets to tackle Japan in the Pacific and Germany-Italy in Europe. Next up was North Africa, where the young and ill-experienced troops of the U.S. would slowly fight their way to gain control of North Africa. Then from here, the U.S. moved up to Sicily and Italy, where the U.S. would take. Then comes France and one of the most famous battles of U.S. history, D-Day.
After D-Day, America kept pushing and pushing throughout Europe,
gaining more ground every day, until the Ardennes in Belgium. When Nazi Germany called an all-out attack on the Allies, the troops in the Ardennes were told to hold their positions at all costs and wait for help to show up. Help finally did show up after 19,000 American casualties dead, but the Allies won the battle. Finally pushed their way to the capital of Germany, Berlin. Here the forces of the US, Britain, and the Soviets would attack the capital and finally take down Nazi Germany. Now that Nazi Germany is finally out of the war, America can finally turn its full attention to Japan and Pacific. Up until now, the US had stopped the westward expansion of Japan. Through island hopping, we stopped them at Midway, Guadalcanal, Iwo Jima, Okinawa, and many more. Now all that is left is the home islands of Japan, which if a ground attack was taken would have taken months, maybe even years, plus the cost of American casualties, but we had a better solution.
Sunny August morning, Hiroshima had no premonition of its fate. On Tinian Island in the Marianas, a B-29 named the Enola Gay prepared to make the first atomic bomb run. Over Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the course of world history took a new turn. The new weapon blasted the enemy completely out of the war. Japan no longer had the will to fight. Hiroshima lay in ruins. Within a few seconds, the sizable city had been demolished by the atomic blast.
But they still refused to surrender. On September 2nd, 1945, Japan officially surrendered to the United States on the USS Missouri, finally ending this war. Coming out of the war, two superpowers were left, US and the Soviets. But before more fighting begins in other wars, we finally have time to rest. The nation is back to normal, out of depression, and happy to see loved ones come back home. This really was the end to the world's great war.
Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again.